Good morning, my friends. Hugs. This is Proof Weight Loss Surgery Works. And you know who I am, Gastric Rose. Okay, the question is this. How do you learn to live with excess skin, wrinkles, and leftover signs of your obesity? What advice would you offer to someone who struggles to feel good looking in their smaller body, lower weight, and excess skin? What advice would I give you? You know, guys, I have totally forever said I had to learn to stop beating myself up. I had to stop tearing myself up. Because that's what I would do when I'd look in the mirror. I would literally say things to me in the mirror that I wouldn't dare say to a friend. But yet, it was okay for me to say it to me. Why is that? Why do we beat ourselves up? I had to learn to embrace this body the way it is today. I had to learn to love myself in ways that no one could love for me. Does that make sense? I knew people loved me. I knew people told me that I had gotten smaller and I had a tiny waist. But yet, the only thing I see sometimes is my hips. I don't even see my arms as much. Yeah, they're there. Those are signs. And if you know me from a while back, if you know me, you know what I say about my arms. I say they are my trophies. They're signs of me being who I was. You know? And I'm proud of that. So, let me stop and give you a quote real fast. Love yourself enough to take the actions required for your happiness. Enough to cut yourself loose from the drama-filled past. Enough to set a high standard for relationships, for friendships. Enough to feed your mind and body in a healthy manner. Enough to forgive. Yeah. Forgive myself. Yourself. And enough. Love yourself enough to move on, to move forward. I had to learn to do that because, you know, in so much of my life, it held me back. I couldn't move forward because I didn't know how to forgive what I had done to my body. But even when you don't love your body will still love you. Right? You still have breath in your body. You can still wake up in the morning. You get up. That body is loving on you. It woke you up. It told you it's time to get up. It gave you a hug, right? There's nothing wrong with your body, but there is a lot wrong with the messages which try to convince you otherwise. I remember a good friend was struggling with loving her body. And you all know who this friend is. Wendy. Many years ago. And I convinced her to look in the mirror and find something good about it, about her body, every day. And begin to believe it. Begin to embrace it. And to embrace it within that day. You know, years have passed, and she has surpassed the body that she thought she couldn't embrace. And I thank, every day, I thank my body for what it's given me. And I've embraced me. You know? I'm going to get as small as I'm going to get, but that doesn't give me everything. Doesn't give me everything. Doesn't give me the confidence that I have today to go into a pool. It doesn't give me the confidence that, you know, I can be sleeveless. Yes! Yes! Yes, 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 yes. There was days that I was a slave to those sweaters in the summer. Today is my tomorrow. It's up to me to shape it, to take control and seize every single opportunity. Mm-hmm. The power is in the choices I make each day to eat well, to live well, and to shape me. To shape me. So without further ado, I'm going to show you a clip of me showing you some skin. Be right back. For me, I'm going to show you in a bathing suit because I'm not as brave as some of you. I commend the ones that can do it. But mama ain't going to do it. Anyway, you don't need to see it. It's just a lot of skin. And it's not as if you can't see it. I can get as close as I can. But this is my body. All right. I did have my stomach removed. It used to hang to my knees about right here. And I didn't get my legs done, so I've got the skin that folds down. I have the arms. I have this that I call it my double boobage that, you know, I would love to wear a blouse that didn't show the extra skin. I don't know. I'm trying to get as close as I can so you can see this right here. It's like it folds, and it drives me crazy. But it doesn't fold here, because when they pulled on my stomach, they also got the inside and did where they did the muscles. Anyway, so my issue is my legs. It always has been my legs. You know, I work on me every day, every single day. You know, some days I can't make it to the pool, but I'm doing something. And I'm trying to get as close as possible because you can't see me from far. But these are shorts that I wear to the pool. You know, I try and be as modest as I can. You know, what can I do? I can't get... This is as modest as this going to get. You know, but... You know, this is the issue I deal with. This flap. I would love to wear, like I said, blouses. And that didn't show that flap. And I wear a bra because, you know... I'm 53 years old, and things are going south. And, of course, my bathing suit, I tried to wear a bigger bathing suit that would, you know, hold these in. But then it's big everywhere else, so I have issues of it falling. So the only solution I came up with it was a bra. Because no matter how much you pull on these suckers, you know, don't work on me. I'm so embarrassed. I'm all red. Okay, so I wasn't completely, you know, naked or anything like that, but I can't help it. I'm just modest. So, without making this too long, I want you to repeat these words, if you can. There's a lot of things that. A lot of us have issues with, you know. Mine are my legs and the little flap I have on the sides. Yours might be other, you know. Everybody has something. Everybody has something. Even the models, even the ones that are already, you know, gorgeous. And not that we're not gorgeous, but I'm just saying the ones that, you know, are being portrayed on magazines and things like that, you know. And even they have issues, you know? So I want you to say with me, affirm this for you. I will focus on my positive points, not my flaws. I will let go of criticizing my imperfections. I will let it go. I will let go of the idea that to be attractive, I must be thin. There's nothing wrong with being thin. That's not the issue. That's not the issue, and you know it. But having the idea that's the only way that you can be attractive is the problem. I will let go of comparing my body to anyone else's. And I will appreciate my body as it is, even if it's hard to lose weight at times. And that is by Judith, I'm going to mess up this name, Orloff. And I'm going to put it here at the end. And I want you to start saying that. I want you to start believing in your body. Start loving what you see in the mirror today. It may not be like that next year. It may not be like that. It may be up some. It may be down some. It may be just the way you wanted it. But at least, you're going to love what you see in the mirror and be more positive and be more kind. If you didn't get anything in this video, I want you to hold on to these words. Be kind to you. To you. You're kind to everybody else. Stop and be kind to you. I love you guys. I hope you stayed till the end. And leave me a comment. I'll see you when I see you. Oh, I'll see you next Sunday. How's that? Bye. I love you guys.